Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our second music night. My name's Michael Degenhardt, and I'm director of music at Westminster. Just a few quick reminders for tonight. Sitting in family groups is fine, but please allow a distance between each group. Looks like you're doing the right thing. Well done. If you need to exit during the concert, please use only the doors through the foyer. And at interval, and once the concert's finished, can you please exit from the theatre using only the side exits? And that's easily opened by just pushing the door bars. We ask respectfully that you please do not congregate in the foyer, and as we know, the Friends of Music usually do a great job with refreshments, but unfortunately, we're not able to offer refreshments this evening. Thank you again for your tolerance. I'd like to introduce Emily, who is our 2020 Captain of Music.
Good evening, everyone. We would like to acknowledge that the land we meet on today is the traditional lands of the Kaurna people, and that we respect their spiritual relationship with their country. We also acknowledge the Kaurna people as the traditional custodians of the Adelaide region, and that their cultural and heritage beliefs are still as important to the living Kaurna people today. As a courtesy to the performers and others around you, would you please ensure that all mobile phones are switched off this evening? In the event of an emergency, please locate your nearest exit. This may be towards the back of the auditorium or through the side door exits. Child protection laws prohibit filming of tonight's concert, but thanks to Mr. McLaughlin, the concert will be accessible on the school's YouTube channel. We sincerely hope you enjoy tonight's performance, but firstly, I'd like to talk a little bit about our first piece. From the first time two steamboats met and passed each other on the Mississippi River, pilots and owners have competed to see whose boat was the fastest. Perhaps the most famous of these races occurred in the summer of 1870 between the Robert E. Lee and the Natchez. In June of 1870, the Natchez made a record-breaking run from New Orleans to St. Louis in 3 days, 21 hours, and 58 minutes. Captain T.P. Leathers and the Natchez were hailed as the fastest on the Great River. Captain John W. Cannon on the Robert E. Lee decided that the success of the Natchez could not go unanswered. While waiting for the Natchez to return to New Orleans, he readied his great steamboat for the race by stripping her of excess weight and declining all passengers and cargo. Captain Leathers of the Natchez welcomed the challenge. However, he refused to lighten his load. On the last day of June 1870, the new boats left New Orleans and hurried up the river, with the Natchez carrying passengers and a full cargo load. Captain Cannon had arranged for barges to be floated alongside the Robert E. Lee to alleviate docking for the refueling process. In order to stay in the race, the Natchez was forced to do the same in response. The race continued, with each boat paddling furiously up the river. Along the route, a thick fog settled over the famously tricky river. Piloting the great steamboats through the constantly changing river required visibility. Thus, the two boats throttled their boilers to a standstill, waiting for nature's permission to continue the race. As the fog lifted, the race ensued on the final leg to St. Louis. The Robert E. Lee was victorious, arriving in St. Louis a full 6 hours and 25 minutes ahead of the Natchez. The Great Steamboat Race by Robert W. Smith draws upon this historic event as its inspiration. From the paddle wheels churning the muddy water to the melodious calliope on the Robert E. Lee, the composition brings the sounds and intensity of the great race to the concert stage. If you listen carefully, you may even be able to hear the great ships throttling down as the fog sets in, only to resume the race in a final push to the finish line. The Robert E. Lee, with his calliope singing, steams ahead of the Natchez in the final moments, leaves the great Mississippi River in peaceful silence. Please welcome the Senior Wind Ensemble, directed by Mr. Darrell Hope, OAM.
Good evening. My name is Josh Gomez, and I'm the leader of the Senior Wind Ensemble and the leader of Strings and Orchestra. For many years, our senior concert band grew to at one stage to have around 90 members. With the advent of Year 7 students joining Westminster, it was an opportunity for us to split the concert bands. We rebranded them as the Intermediate Wind Ensemble and the Senior Wind Ensemble, with both the two new directors. The Senior Wind Ensemble is made up of mostly 10 to 12 students and has worked really well preparing for this year's Abode Festival and tonight's concert. We performed... Abode was online this year, so we performed for that. The Great Steamboat Race was one of the pieces we played for that festival, and tonight we aired the first time Stevie Wonder medley, which we enjoyed playing. The Senior String Ensemble and Senior Orchestra have also grown this year. The Senior String Ensemble performed Gabriel's Oboe, which will feature Jack McDonald on the oboe, who also plays alto sax and Big Ben Wand. We'd also like to remember Eddie Mericone, who was a wonderful composer who passed away earlier this year. This will be followed by Tarantella, written by Larissa Finn, also one of the set pieces for this year's Abode Festival. The String Ensemble is directed by Miss Jenny Simons. That will be followed by a Senior Orchestra who performs Hungarian Dance and the Sorcerer's Apprentice. The Senior Orchestra is directed by Miss Chris Gould. Please welcome Senior String Ensemble.
Next up is the Gomez family, who call themselves Fortune 8, derived from four kids, lots of tunes and eight instruments, though that's changed a bit recently. Josh is in year 12, Hannah's in year 10, Sarah's in year 7, all on violin, and Ben is in year 5 on cello. It's especially important that they play and rehearse well because they form a string quartet that Josh is using for his Stage 2 solo performance for SAS. They've been playing together since Ben was 2 years old, and that's when they did some Christmas busking in Rundle Mall. And earlier this year, they made it through the first rounds to get into the first live audition of Australia's Got Talent. So 1 week before they were due to fly to Sydney, COVID arrived. So tonight they've decided to play for you what they would have done for their live audition. So would you please welcome Fortune 8 and Star Wars. For their second piece, Fortune 8 will be playing You Raise Me Up. Every school holidays, they play in nursing homes, and this is a favourite with the residents. During COVID, obviously, they haven't been allowed to into these nursing homes, so they decided to pick up and try a couple of new instruments. So here is You Raise Me Up, dedicated to all the nursing homes around Australia.
Thank you.
tree before indoor. That was pretty good, I thought. An ensemble, according to the sideboard, is two or more players with each player on separate parts. Some of you may remember the stunning piano duet at last year's Music Night featuring old scholar Ting Yun and our very own Chris Gould on two separate pianos. Well, I couldn't convince Mr. Shepherd to spend $250,000 on the Bösendorf we had on loan last year. So tonight's piano duet is on one piano. Yolanda Fang is studying solo performance and ensemble performance on piano and has worked very hard this year. Tonight she will be joined by Chris Gould once again on one piano and on one piano stool. And they will perform Jewish Fantasy. After this, there'll be a short 10-minute interval. Unfortunately, we're not able to offer refreshments, as I said earlier, but I encourage you to take the opportunity to stretch your legs, ready for a very exciting second half of the concert. Would you please welcome Yolanda Fang and Chris Gould.
Thank you.
Josh has caught the eye of some of the assessors that have come to Westminster to provide valuable feedback to all of our solo performers, including staff from Adelaide University. His versatile display of varying techniques all adds to the engaging performance on guitar. Tonight, Josh will perform Flamen by Sungajum. Please welcome Josh.
Thank you. Bush, a piece we enjoyed playing. This featured Tim Blisnell on guitar and Riley Newsom-Burns on trumpet. Would you please join me in welcoming Gemma Dandy. She is studying voice for solo performance this year and will join the band to sing a tune called Orange Colored Sky. Please welcome Gemma.
We've been fortunate over many years to host a number of special guests who've worked with our students during Music Week. And we did have some lined up this year, but one's from Victoria and one's from New South Wales, so that wasn't possible. So given the year it's been, we thought focusing on a bunch of very special people, our Year 12 students, would be a great compromise. They're a talented group, and having taught a few of them from Year 5 upwards, where some began their instrumental journey, we were really looking forward to working with this group when this group arrived in Year 12 and all that would bring, but it didn't quite happen the way we or they expected. So you've heard of a few already tonight in various aspects, various ensembles, and we thought it might be worth just getting the Year 12s to feature in their own number, one they picked. Making a decision on the piece required constant badgering from staff, which is typical, but they decided eventually on the great Earth, Wind and Fire classic, September. They're going to be aided by Blush again on bass, the only instrument they couldn't cover themselves. So, ladies and gentlemen, our very special guest for this year, the class of 2020.
Thank you. year or so, Vocal Jazz One have been pretty well known for our renditions of Queen songs. And this started with Somebody to Love, which we performed last year at Music Night. This was followed by Under Pressure, which we performed recently at Sing Sing Sing. And tonight, we are going to be continuing this tradition by performing our version of Don't Stop Me Now, with a solo by Emmy Beattie. This will be followed by Hallelujah, I Love Him So, which will be accompanied by some of the members of Big Band One, and includes a solo by Jack Degenhart and Tim Lizzo. Our rhythm section this evening includes Andrew Casey on piano, Malush on bass, Tim Lizzo on guitar, and Sam Miller on drums. And some of our horn players include Jack McDonald on alto sax, Jack Degenhart on baritone sax, Sam Lizzo and Mr. Degenhart on trumpet, and Alex Taylor on trombone. So please welcome to the stage Vocal Jazz One under the direction of Chris Gould.
And the world is turning inside out, yeah.
So we've just about come to the last item for this evening's concert, and it's my pleasure to welcome the Senior Vocal Ensemble on stage. This is the largest ensemble at Westminster.
And where we look down the way. what a concept, but I love singing with my friends, and with harmony the world can change. Hey now, you're an all-star, so get your game on and play.
Hey now, you're an all-star, gotta get the show on
and get paid. Oh, that glitters is gold, is gold.
Can shine
if you're young or you're.
7, 8. Singing for the whole world, the boy or girl, be your number one fan. K.O. wanna be, okay? I'm a human, ain't no way. Go ahead, don't sing it, don't talk, cause the beat won't stop, no way.
Thanks for coming along. Safe travels.